Florida state leaders are cracking down on abortion. Florida Attorney General Ashley Moody is exploring ways to eliminate the so-called right to abortion that currently exists in the state's constitution. And the state is fining a Central Florida abortion clinic in the amount of $193,000 for failing to abide by pro-life state laws. While many red states have moved to ban almost all abortions, Florida is the only state that currently has a 15-week limit on abortion in effect, according to Susan B. Anthony, Pro-Life America's LifesavingLaws.com. And joining me now is Anthony Sabatini. He serves Florida's 32nd District in the Florida State House. Thanks so much for joining me, Rep. Sabatini. You've served in the State House since 2018, so talk to me about the legislation that you've supported to stop abortions and save babies in your state.
Sure. Well, obviously, we're very happy about the Dobbs decision. It's opened up a lot of new opportunities for the state of Florida to go much further in protecting the lives of unborn children. So this year, we passed a 15-week ban. I think that's a good start. But really, I've been pushing for a much stronger set of protections for unborn children. And I do believe that the heartbeat bill is going to pass, which is a moving the prohibition period for having an on-demand abortion to 6 weeks. I think that's going to pass this spring. So we're pretty excited about that. Of course, I believe life begins at conception. I think we need a total ban on abortion. But I think for Florida, the next step is going to the heartbeat bill.
Absolutely. And I want to talk a little more about that. You know, it took a long time for Florida to enact its 15-week limit. So what's it going to take for stronger protections to be passed? You know, now that Roe has gone, over a dozen red states have essentially banned abortion altogether. Florida's the only one that has this 15-week limit.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. I was very much a critic of the bill. I mean, anytime you're getting closer to stronger protections for pro-life, you know, I support that, but we should have went much further. I mean, when the country of France has stronger protections for unborn children than your state in the United States, that's an epic failure. So I want us to go in a much stronger direction, but the problem was twofold. One, we had really bad state Supreme Court precedent. We used to have a very liberal state Supreme Court, which enacted an interpretation of the state privacy clause that was even more stringent than the federal constitution, so therefore more pro-choice or pro-death, if you will, than even what the federal constitution allowed. So we had to get over that hump by getting new justices. And second of all, we just need more willpower amongst our legislature. You know, our legislature is not as strong as Governor DeSantis. I don't think they're doing enough to push a stronger bill, but I do think after the election, you're going to see a lot more pressure get put on the Republican legislators and see if they'll join my position, which is going further than 15 weeks.
Well, thanks for that insight. And, you know, Rep. Sabatini, we talk on this show a lot, not just about ending abortions, but also restoring a culture that totally protects families and children. Talk to me a little bit about the biggest problems that families in Florida are facing right now and what you're doing to solve those problems.
Sure. Well, obviously, the biggest problems in the country right now are this horrible economy, which is robbing from the middle class, the working class, the stagnation that we're seeing, the inflation, the robbery at the gas pump. That's all by design. It's all been designed by the Democrats, not just accidental. They really do enjoy putting environmental climate change agenda more than alleviating pain of the middle class and working classes of the country. So we need to change that. And the best thing to do that is through tax cuts and economic mobility, economic opportunity, and also fighting the Biden crime wave. You know, the Democrats, in my opinion, are a party that doesn't mind crime. They don't really have an issue with massive amounts of crime and violence in the streets. And so, you know, I believe that we need to end crime. We need to be tougher on crime. And those are the two big things we're taking very seriously in Florida, with Governor DeSantis passing stronger, tough on crime policies, and also things to alleviate the pain of this Biden economy and do tax cuts. I think those are important things. But I think the biggest thing we can do to revive parental rights and family and really to have a religious revival in this country is go to a universal school choice system. We need to go further for school choice. We need to have 100% school choice so we can get more children in Christian education at no cost to their parents.
Yeah.
They're already paying for a public school system that's largely secular and materialistic. We need to move away from that.
Well said. And we have about 30 seconds left, but I want to ask you, I know you're a fellow Catholic. How does your faith motivate you to fight for the family? I also noticed you recently announced that you're expecting a baby. So congratulations on that.
Thank you. We're very excited and really looking forward to my first child. And Yeah, my Catholic faith informs everything I do. It's one of the things that induced me to get involved in politics, of reading a lot of Catholic and Christian literature is what made me think I needed to get involved in the public sphere. So it's foundational for me.
That's great to know. Well, we're praying for you in your fight to make Florida more pro-life. Thanks for joining us today, State Representative Anthony Sabatini.
Thank you. God bless. Take care.